Hey guys, Mr. here again for another video today, and we are back with our Winnipeg Jets franchise mode. So in the last one, it was a bit of a different one, but we are back with our regular episodes, I guess. But we are going to be making a trade. So I have decided who I'm going to trade for. It was between TJ Brody of the Calgary Flames, who looks pretty good, to be honest. He's a pretty good offensive defenseman. We need a defenseman that can put up points. And also PK Subban from the Nashville Predators. So those were the two that I decided to go after. And you know what? For what Subban is worth, I have decided to go for TJ Brody. TJ Brody is nowhere near as expensive, both contract-wise and stuff we have to give up-wise. So TJ Brody has a $4.655 million contract for 2 years, and PK Subban has a contract of $9 million for the next 4 years. And we have some pretty massive contracts on this team already as it is, so not only is this going to clear up some space, but we also will more than likely have a good offensive defenseman to play top 2 minutes. So this is going to be the trade that we're going to try. I don't think this will go through, but we're going to try it. They do want to get rid of Brody, so you never know. So Tyler Myers, Sammy Niku, and our Winnipeg Jets first round pick of this upcoming draft. I was going to say, just for shits and giggles, I will retain salary, but it's not going to be a lot. Let's see, how much could I retain? I don't think I could do 50. I could go over 25. Could I do 30? I could do over 30. How about 40? I could. Maybe I could even do 50%. Could I? I could. All right. Well, I mean, I'll try to retain that salary. So this is definitely not going to go through, but proposed trade. So yeah, trade rejected. I mean, I don't plan on being a bad team. So hopefully we can make sure that hopefully we can ensure this trade by using other draft picks, which I feel like a 2021 second round pick could push this through. Let's try it. Proposed trade. Trade rejected. They aren't willing to retain that much salary, and to be honest, that works out, because to be honest, they probably shouldn't, and that would also mean that we won't have to sign anybody just to be in the cap, or to have the salary cap hit perfectly in between the max and the minimum. So we'll try this with 10% retained just because. Proposed trade. Trade rejected still. Okay, well, let's try and just retaining 0% for Brody. Proposed trade here. Trade accepted. All right. So TJ Brody is now a Winnipeg Jet, which I think is really cool. Let's see. So he's probably our best defenseman, if not Trouba, maybe Byfuglien, to be honest. I'm not sure. It depends, I guess. So we are going to go to defense really quickly. We are going to take out... Oh, God. I don't know what I'm going to do. We're going to switch out... Okay, wait, what are the special teams looking like? Alright, so let's switch out Morrissey for Brody. Brody will be getting the top two ice time. Then we'll switch out Davidson for Morrissey. And then we will switch out no one for Davidson, I guess, technically. Substitute in all lines. And I think that is good now. So Brody we'll be getting the top line ice time with Jacob Trouba, then Byfuglien and Morrissey, and Kulikov and Davidson. Both our bottom pair are both lefties, but it's fine. Now I do want to check these special teams. I do not want Davidson here. Is Brody here? Yes, he is. Okay. So the other one I want is Morrissey. Obviously, Brody's gonna get the top two ice time though. Four man. We will also switch Davidson for Morrissey, switch those two around, switch Brody and Byfuglien around, then switch Trouba and Brody around. Penalty kill, we'll do the same thing. Instead of Davidson, we'll switch Morrissey. We'll switch Brody and by Fuglin, and that's good. All right, three-man PK. We'll switch Davidson for Morrissey again. And then we'll switch Morrissey and Byfuglin there. I didn't want to do pest lines because that could have definitely screwed up everything. And it just would have been way too long to deal with. I do want Brody on the top pair, though. I didn't even realize I did that. So we'll switch it like that. I think that is fine. Now let's go to extras. Again, instead of Davidson, we will put on Morrissey. We'll switch Brody and Byfuglin again. Just because, all right, then, yeah, that is fine. 3-on-3. Trouba, Brody, Byfuglin, that is good. Extra attacker, that's fine. And shootout, that should still be fine. All right, so that will be the lines. Now for the AHL, since we took Niku out, we're going to have to replace him. Now, who we will replace him with, I do not know. Do we even have a defenseman that is good enough? Not really. Goto Vets or Daly? Which, to be honest, kind of sucks. So, I mean, okay, well, let's switch out this spot for Nogier. Nogier can get the main ice time there. Then we'll switch out Nogier here for Daly, I guess. Will that switch both of them? It will too. Alright, well, we're going to have to scratch Daly here. Scratch him. Yeah, we'll scratch him. And then on the top pair, we will put on Nogier, which basically fills up all the lines. And then Daly can get that one. We'll switch out Melchiori with Daly, and I think that is good now. So, hopefully this team is a little bit better than last year's. I think it might be, but you never know. If you guys do not remember the lines, I will show you them really quickly. So, Laine, Scheifele, and Ehlers on the top pair with Wheeler, Perreault, and Connor. Wheeler already got back up to an 86 somehow. I didn't even realize that. I'm assuming just for getting Brody, he's back up to an 86. Yep, all right, well, that was a lot easier than I thought it would have been to get him back up to his regular overall, but that's good. He is still listed as a first liner, but I'm giving him plenty of ice time, so he shouldn't complain about his ice time, but then again, you never know. He still might. So let's get the sim going, boys. I think it is finally time. Actually, I want to go to settings. I forgot to turn up the gameplay sliders here. So we'll turn it up to 8 again, even with Houston at 8. Have not gotten an injury. I'll go to rules just to make sure that injuries are on. Injuries are on, so apparently lowering the sliders actually really lower it this year, which, I mean, last year wasn't this bad, but all right, let's see. Now, no one could get injured until the preseason, which is good. Like, no one will get injured in practice or anything, which is good. So let's see how the preseason goes. So far 1-1-0, which isn't too bad, I guess. I mean, whatever. So let's go start the scouting in the WHL. We'll usually, as I normally do, we'll probably just stick with North America. We'll do that first, then we'll switch over to Sweden and Russia after that. All right, well, so 2-4-0 is not a very good record in the preseason. Then again, it was the preseason, so yeah, that was kind of shocking. I was hoping it would be a little bit better than that, but unfortunately it just wasn't. So we have not played a game yet. Obviously, first game is against Minnesota this year, so let's go. Before we do this, I do want to see the draft class for this year. Should have Svechnikov and Tkachuk in here, I believe. It should, since they weren't in the last one. Brady Tkachuk is, but Brady Tkachuk is, but did he must have gone then. Did Svechnikov get drafted this year? Okay, well, he must have. What team did he get drafted by, though? I do not know. Did he get drafted? I think. I'm pretty sure he did. I don't remember. So for some reason, they got screwed up. Like, Svechnikov didn't get drafted in Houston, and then, I don't know, it's weird. All right, let's see. So obviously not on our team. I didn't mean to do that. Anaheim, I'll assume, wouldn't have them. I do not remember who won the lottery, so we'll just check some bad teams. So Arizona got Valeno. Buffalo, they got Mittelstadt, as they actually did, I believe. I believe so. Moving on, Carolina. Did Carolina get him? Nope. How about Colorado? Colorado, no. All right. Dallas, maybe. I doubt it, but maybe. No, they just got Heiskanen. Detroit. They got McGillney, who I think went later. Yeah, he went later in the draft. So, I mean, eh. Florida, maybe? I honestly don't know. Philip Zadina went to Florida. All right. LA. I mean, I could check LA. Maybe they fell off again. No, just gave Velarde still. New Jersey, maybe, has Svechnikov. No, they have Cale Makar, though. The Islanders, maybe. I do not know. Anderson McDonald is who they drafted. Rangers might. Maybe because of the pick from Arizona, but nope, they still got Elias Anderson. Ryan McLeod and Benoit Grew went to Ottawa. Philly, maybe? Do they have Svechnikov? No, they got Patrick, obviously, though. I don't know why I'm checking Pittsburgh. San Jose, maybe St. Louis? Nope. No, maybe Vancouver. Vancouver, right. No, really? Just Elias Pettersson. Vegas, then, has Svechnikov? No, they just got Brännström and Dahlin. Capitals, no. Okay, wait, who the hell? Did Svechnikov get drafted or not? I'm so confused. Honestly, I have no idea. He's not on the free agent list, is he? I hope. I know that's what happened with some players. No, he's not. Well, I'm so confused then. I have no idea why. Whatever, all right. Speaking of free agency, though, Derek Forbort would definitely make the defenseman better. He could play, he's listed as a top four, though. I don't have a spot for him to play top four. I mean, Kevin Gravel is top six, but is it really that much of an improvement? Never mind. All right, well, I don't know where Svechnikov is. We'll have to check the rookies at the end of this year, I guess. I have no idea. So, yeah, all right, well, I guess we will start the sim to hopefully have a better season than the last one. Look to improve on the last one. I mean, the last one wasn't too bad overall, but we'll sim the first month of games, and we'll see how we do. We start off the season pretty poorly, losing three of our first four games. Four of our first five games. Now against Colorado, who isn't doing good either. Let's see, can we beat them? We do beat them. Dallas now in a back-to-back. We get two wins, which is good, on a three-game win streak. We are now back to even, which is good. I'm pretty sure Brady Tkachuk might be in the rest of the world, but I honestly do not know. So I'm not going to scout there yet, because I didn't assign him to a team because I couldn't. Yeah. All right. So in our first 10, we went 4-6-0, which is not a very good record. And in our first month, we went 5-7-0, which also is not a very good record. Which means what? Which means, do I need to make some line changes? Line A's scoring goals this year. He is the leading point scorer, so That is good. What is the problem with the team, though? I mean, not a lot of points up on that top line. Let's switch Ehlers and Wheeler. Not a lot of points on that first line. Not a lot of points on the second line, or on the third or fourth line either. Defensively, Brody, how's he doing? He's doing good, which is good. Again, we just need more points from our defensemen, really. I mean, Brody's doing good. He's 6 points in 9 games, which isn't bad. But Trouba, not a lot of points. Morrissey, not a lot of points. Byfuglien, not a lot of points. Kulikov's not doing too bad, and not a single point from Davidson. I feel like I might have to pin this on Mason. How good is. Well, I mean, 923 save percentage of 2.01 GAA is not bad. But for some reason, Hellebuck's got put in so many times. He has a 285. Huh. I don't know how I feel about that. You know what? I think I might turn auto rotate goalies off then, because the way that Hellebuck is playing is not very good, and I don't feel confident with him backing up Steve Mason right now. So I will turn off the auto rotate goalies. And maybe that does something. I don't know. I don't really know. Other than that Ehlers and Wheeler line change, I don't really know what else to do. Like, I mean, I was gonna say we're kind of a defensive team, but we j aren't really. Like, we aren't really playing that well defensively either. We aren't really scoring too many goals. Well, let's sim another month, and we'll see if this month is any better. Maybe we just needed to get warm up a little bit. Obviously, new team, and I'm pretty sure on a 4-game losing streak as well. Now, for sure, a four. Never mind. We did win against Calgary. We won against New York. Can we even our record up and go 10-10 again, please? Because so far, we are not doing good. Did I just go OHL? No, I didn't. All right. So far we aren't doing good, which is unfortunate. You would think with this team we would be pretty decent, but I don't know what is going on. I don't know if there is someone to blame. Like, should I be blaming Steve Mason? Should I be blaming our offense and just the lack of scoring goals? I mean, I say the lack of scoring goals. I mean, we did score 7 goals in one game once against Nashville, but Nashville was a really good team too, so surprisingly enough, we did beat them. But I do not know. 19 points for Scheifele in 25 games. I mean, by no means is that bad. I just need to figure something out. 12 goals for Line A is good. Scheifele's doing good. Wheeler's doing good. Second line, doing good. Third line, not too bad. I mean, on this, like at this rate, Joel Armia could be getting a 20 goal season. I'm just trying to think. You know what? Kunackle is gonna get the line change with Patan. Kunackle's just getting more points. We need a more offensive third line, that's for sure. Defensively now, Brody's still doing good. Trouba hasn't gotten a point since I last checked. You know what? Let's switch Byfuglien and Trouba then. Kulikov, Davidson's gotten a few points. I don't really know if there's anything else to change. Mason, not doing too good. Let's try a few games with Hellebuck then. I mean, a 921 save percentage is much better than a 911 save percentage that Hellebuck has. But we'll try this. Let's see if Hellebuck's starting a few games. Maybe he does a little bit better. We are currently second worst in our division. Let's sim three games. Yeah, we'll sim 3 games with Hellebuck in net, and we'll try this. He loses the first one, wins the second one, and loses the third one. You know what? We'll give him 5 games, and we'll see how he does. In game four, he loses. All right, well, he's gonna get switched out then. He is gonna get switched out then in just a minute. Once we're done this, and once we, yeah, okay, yeah, it was just fucking terrible stats from Connor Hellebuck there. I don't know what to do, man. I feel like we just need a better goalie. Neither of our goalies are doing good. We're second worst in the division right now. And of course, I traded away our first round pick this year. I did think about trading it, trading next year's too, but apparently I should have. I don't know, man. Like, what is there even anything to change? Let's put Mason back in net. 919. He did get put in for Hellebuck. Hellebuck only has 3 wins in 12 games. Mason has 8 and 22. Now, I don't know. I feel like it should be a goalie trade because I am not feeling too happy about how well it's going right now. Let's see. Actually, I don't want to do it like this. Let's go and check the trade block, and we'll see if there's any goalies out there I could go for that is maybe better or just doing better, I guess. Let's browse the trade block and let's see what is there. Max Jones, Arizona, doesn't have a goalie. Boston doesn't have a goalie. Does any team have a goalie that is decent they would like to give up? Not looking like it, to be honest. Dallas, nope. Detroit, no. Edmonton, no. Florida, no. LA, no. Minnesota, Carter Hutton's just not worth it. I need a starter. No. Mark Stahl, no. Subban is still there. I mean, maybe I could go after him still. Marcus Johansson's there. That wouldn't be bad. He's on the last year of his deal. Faneuf, no. I know I've been looking for goalies, and I just talked about that Tristan Jarry, 78 overall, is too low. Nobody on St. Louis. Nobody on Tampa. Tampa wants to get rid of Cal Foot, though. Interesting. Toronto, Kapanen, Derek Dorsett, Chara signed with the Golden Knights, Washington, and that's it. Well, what team was it that had Cal Foot? All right, Tampa has Cal Foot. That would be interesting. I don't know. I do not know what to do. I feel like we need a better goalie because I feel like our goalie tandem is not good. Which, to be honest, could we... how much value does Hellebuck have currently? Let's see. Just out of curiosity, we might try something. I might try something. So Hellebuck has a decent amount of value. Let's go to Calgary. How expensive is our first round pick? Probably expensive, yeah. So really, we wouldn't be able to give up on Hellebuck. We'd have to give up on Mason. They'd be over the max cap. We could retain salary. He is on the last year of his deal. If we retain 50%, is that enough? It is enough. Will that go through one for one? Values on our side, proposed trade, that would go through, all right. Could we get something back? Just out of curiosity, could we get something back? Could we get a third back from them? Proposed trade, we could. All right, well, let's see if we can get more then. Let's try and get a third in next year's draft as well. Proposed trade. Trade rejected, all right. How about... No, I'd like the third of this year. And we'll also just add the fourth, I guess. Proposed trade. Trade rejected, all right. We'll try a 6 then if okay, well, they don't have a 6. We'll try the 6 in next year's draft. Proposed trade. That will go through. We'll make that trade now. Steve Mason, goodbye. We get our first round pick back, which is needed apparently. In the system, we need to call up Comrie. All right, confirm. Let's go to edit lines, and I think we might just roll with Comrie and Hellebuck then. Yeah, maybe Comrie could be good as a rookie goaltender for us. I mean, I doubt it, but you never know. Yeah, I think we might just roll with these two. I'm glad we got our first round pick back, though. If we roll with these two, and we'll see what to do. Just gonna have to do best lines, I think. Because I don't think we have another goalie down in the AHL. Oh, we do. Grow. Alright, well, Grow can play. Yeah, whatever. We'll just keep Phillips as the starter. You know what? Let's give Eric Comrie a few games before I end the episode here. Let's give him a few games, and we'll see how he does. Rookie goaltender may need to carry this team, which, I mean, it could happen. You never know. But we're going to need something magical to happen for this team to make the playoffs now. I don't know why we are so bad, to be honest. I really don't. All right, let's see. Let's sim 5 games. We'll get 5 games to Comrie, and we'll see how he does. Yannick Weber, a defensive D-man. I'm just going to decline it. 6-3 loss, all right, in his first ever NHL game. 3-0 lost in his second NHL game. I don't think it's going to happen, boys. I do not think it's going to happen. So let's change some things. Let's edit lines. Let's change the goalies again. And yeah, Comrie's already up to an 80, but I don't know. I might look to make a trade off screen though, guys. So that is going to be it from me. Hopefully you all did enjoy. Thank you very much for watching. Please let me know what you think we should do about this goalie situation, because we are in a rough spot currently. Second worst in the division. It's not very good. But yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you all did enjoy, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.